Dear students, welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. I am very happy to meet again. Today, in this video, we are going to see a new topic. This topic belongs to adrenal gland. You know, it is an endocrine gland. This adrenal gland, otherwise called emergency gland. This gland performs various functions. So in this video, this adrenal gland, where it was located, what is the structure, what is the color, what is the shape, what are the hormones from this gland, what are the functions of these hormones, everything we will see in this video. So please, students, you listen here. Adrenal gland, otherwise called emergency gland. It is called emergency gland. First of all, this gland, where it was located, first location. Okay, you know that kidneys. So, I will draw this, so like this. Kidney is there. So, above the kidney, a cap-like structure. Otherwise, you can say a pyramid-like structure, pyramid. So, like this, above the kidney, a cap-like structure or a pyramid-like structure is there. This gland is called adrenal gland. So, kidney, otherwise, we know that, or you can say renin. What is this? Renin. Kidney, otherwise, called renin. So, above the renin, the gland is present. This gland, pyramid shape or conical shape or cap-like structure, whatever may be. So, this gland, otherwise we can say suprarenal gland. So, why it is called suprarenal gland? It is top of the kidney. Top of the kidney. Maybe this color is yellow, yellowish color, yellowish color. So above the kidney, it was present, so it is called what? Suprarenal gland. So what is the size? Actually, 4 centimeter length and 3 centimeter thickness. So, this is the small size. A cap-like structure is present above the kidney. This is called what? Adrenal gland. This adrenal gland, actually I draw this. It was, there is a variation here. So, this first part, this is called adrenal cortex. And the center part, this is called adrenal medulla. So this gland has two regions. It has two regions or two zones. Two regions are there. The outer region is called adrenal cortex. The second inner portion, the black color portion here, this portion is called adrenal medulla. You know that this gland has two zones. Two regions. So, this is called adrenal cortex. It is outer portion. Whereas this is one. This one is inner portion. Adrenal cortex, adrenal medulla. Even though it was present in the same gland, it was totally different in their structure. Not only structure, and also they are differ their function also. This adrenal cortex performs various function, different function. Whereas adrenal medulla performs different function. So even though it is a single gland, it has two zones, adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla, but these two regions has, they are different in their structure, in their function, and also in their embryological development also. So let us see what is adrenal cortex, what are the hormones from adrenal cortex, What is adrenal medulla? What are the hormones of adrenal medulla? So we will see in next chart. Adrenal gland, I already told you, two zones. One is called adrenal cortex, one is called adrenal medulla. First, let us see what is adrenal cortex. I want to explain in a simple manner, just to follow me. Here, so this is kidney. So above the kidney, a cap-like structure I told. So like this. This is adrenal cortex, adrenal medulla. Okay. Now I want to explain what is the structure of adrenal cortex. You know that already, adrenal cortex is totally different from adrenal medulla. Totally different from adrenal medulla. It has different function, different structure. And medulla also has different structure and different function. So whereas this is adrenal cortex. I want to draw here a simple diagram to understand the various regions of adrenal cortex. This cortex region I am drawing here. So it has adrenal cortex. It has three zones. Again, it has three zones. It has three zones. The first one here, the first zone, the thin layer, the outer layer. Now this region, here I want to draw the same thing in a big size. Here like this. The outer portion. This zone is called zona glamour. Glamourulasa, glamourulasa, zona glamourulasa. Actually, this is 15% total surface. It is 15% zona glamourulasa, the outer layer. It is a thin layer. It is thin. So inside the zona glamourulasa, one more zone is there. So you see this here. I will draw this. So this is the big zone. So compared to outer portion, the middle zone is just widest. So this zone, zona fasciculata, is about zona fasciculata. This is 75%. So it is the widest zone, middle zone. This is the middle zone. The inner zone, this one. Innermost zone. This zone is called the third zone, that is called zona reticularis. Okay, this zone, the outer zone, here I want to draw this. You see this? This zone, the outermost is zona glamourulasa, this one is zona fasciculata, the innermost zone is called zona reticularis. The same thing here in a big way, big size. So these are the three zones present in adrenal cortex. One is called zona glamourulasa, the second one is zona fasciculata, the third one is zona reticularis, fasciculata, glamourulasa. So these are the three zones present in the adrenal cortex. From these three zones, total adrenal cortex secretes three types of hormones. Three types of hormones. What are the hormones? The first one is the outermost zone, is called zona glamourulasa. This zone secretes a group of hormones, is called mineralocorticoids. The second zone, that is called zona fasciculata, this one, middle zone, this secretes a group of hormones, is called glucocorticoids. Whereas the innermost zone, that is only 10% total area surface, only 10% is there. So this reticularis. Zone reticularis secretes some group of hormones. They are called sex corticoids. So from adrenal cortex, totally three types of hormones are, three groups of hormones are released. The outermost zone, this is a zona glandularis, secretes mineralocorticoids. The middle zone, zona fasciculata, secretes glucocorticoids. The innermost zone is called zona reticularis, secretes sex corticoids. So these three group of hormones performs various function. This function we will see. So adrenal cortex, I have told already, it has three zones. The first zone, it is called zona glandularis, zona glandularis, this is the outer layer. Outer layer, only 50% surface area. This zona glandularis secretes a group of hormone that is called mineralocorticoids. So what? Mineralocorticoids. This mineralocorticoids is a group of hormones. The best example is aldosterone. The name itself shows that minerals. So it helps to retain the minerals inside the body. So it's otherwise called salt retaining hormone. This is a salt retaining hormone. We can say that. Outermost layer, only 50% surface in the cortical cortex. This secretes a group of hormones called mineralocorticoids. Best example is aldosterone. It helps to retain the salts or minerals. So it's called salt retaining hormone. Retaining hormone, we can say this. This hormone, the secretion of mineralocorticoids by the adrenal cortex from zona glandularis, stimulated by some other hormones. So these hormones stimulated by two hormones. One is ACTH, adrenocorticotrophic hormone. We know the very well, adrenocorticotrophic hormone. It is a hormone from adenohypophysis, from pituitary gland. So this hormone, why is called adrenocorticotrophic hormone? This hormone stimulate the cortex region of adrenal. So it is called what? Adrenocorticotrophic hormone. So this hormone stimulate the secretion of mineralocorticoids. And also one more hormone is called angiotensin of Ross in kidney function. So these two hormones, they stimulate the secretion of aldosterone from zona glandularis. So this is the one part. So the adrenal cortex has one more region, I already told, that is called zona fasciculata. Fasciculata. So this zone, already I told that it is a middle widest zone, 75% surface totally. This zone secretes a group of hormone that is called glucocorticoids. How about glucocorticoids? The best example is cortisol. Several hormones are there, but here I have only one hormone that is called what? Cortisol. The best example. This zona fasciculata, it is a middle zone, widest zone, and compared to zona glandularis, it is sort of surface is 75%. This secretes glucocorticoids, example cortisol. In function is mainly in retaining of or homeostasis of glucose, or retaining are maintaining the glucose metabolism. The third zone, that is zona reticularis, zona reticularis, innermost zone, only 10% it occupies. This hormone, this zone secretes some group of hormones called sex corticoids. Example, in male it is androgens, it is androgens. So this is the hormone from zona reticularis. So in this mind map we see that adrenal cortex has three zones. The first zone is zona gravidarensis, the second zone is zona fasciculata, the third one is zona reticularis. So these are the general hormones from adrenal cortex. So really three groups of hormone, I have told, three groups of corticoid hormones. One is mineralocorticoids, the second one is glucocorticoids, the third one is sex corticoids. So these three hormones performs several function. So what are the role of mineralocorticoids, what are the functions of glucocorticoids, what are the function of sex corticoids, we will discuss. Let us discuss the functions of mineralocorticoids. The best example is aldosterone. This aldosterone helps to reabsorption of sodium ions and water during urine formation, especially in the nephron, DCT. So totally these mineralocorticoids regulate the water and electrolyte balance of our body by reabsorption of sodium ions and water. So this aldosterone increase the sodium ions, and also it eliminate the potassium and phosphate ions through excretion, other function. And also it maintains the osmotic pressure and the blood pressure. The one more secretion, the aldosterone stimulated, this secretion takes place by adrenocorticotrophic hormone and angiotensin of RAS. RAS means, you know, that renin angiotensin aldosterone system. So this system, especially in the urine formation, you know that already. So these are the important functions of mineralocorticoids, especially maintenance of electrolyte balance of our body. It stimulates the reabsorption of sodium ions and water. It increases the sodium ions. It eliminates potassium and phosphate through excretion. It maintains the osmotic pressure, and also it regulates the blood pressure of the body. This aldosterone, if it is less, secretion takes place inside the body, it causes a disease called Addison disease. So these are the important functions of mineralocorticoids. Now we will see the functions of glucocorticoids. These glucocorticoids, the best example is cortisone and corticosterone, these two hormones. Several hormones are there, but these two hormones are more important. One is cortisone and corticosterone. So these glucocorticoids, glucose name itself shows us, you see this glucose. So it is primarily meant for carbohydrate metabolism. It's primarily meant for carbohydrate metabolism. So this glucocorticoids stimulate the gluconeogenesis. So what is glucose? Gluconeogenesis, whenever we need glucose, whenever there is a short of glucose, what happens? The glucose will form. The formation of glucose is called gluconeogenesis. But what about gluconeogenesis? But this glucose we need essential, we need emergency. So then what happens? This glucose is derived, or they are carried by, this process is called gluconeogenesis, from non-carbohydrate particles. Actually glucose from carbohydrate. But here what happens? We need glucose. So what happens? It stimulates the gluconeogenesis so that we can get more glucose from non-carbohydrate particles, especially from proteins. So this is called gluconeogenesis. and also this lipolysis, it stimulates lipolysis. You know, lipo means lipid, lysis means destruction. So lipid get break down into fatty acids and glycerols. So this also gives energy for that process. And one more process is called proteolysis. Proteo means proteins, lysis means destruction. So proteolysis means this protein will break down into amino acids. The proteins break down into amino acids. So these amino acids are utilized by the cell to form new proteins. So by the help of proteolysis, what happens? The protein will break down. So the final product is amino acids. These amino acids are utilized by the cells to form new proteins. For example, enzyme. If you need enzymes. So if you need enzymes or hormones, whatever may be. So to get enzymes, so new proteins will form with the help of proteolysis. So these three processes, it is called gluconeogenesis, lipolysis and proteolysis, this is called life-saving process. Whenever we need glucose molecules more, if there is a shortage of glucose, means immediately our body, what happens, this cortisone helps to increase the glucose level by these three processes. One is called gluconeogenesis, one is called lipolysis and one is called proteolysis. So one more function is that this glucocorticoids helps or maintains the cardiovascular function, that is a heart function, and also kidney functions. So it is essential for the both the vital organs. One is called cardiovascular system and also kidney functions. These hormones are essential. These glucocorticoids are very essential. And one more function is that this glucocorticoids, this produce anti-inflammatory reactions. One more important function. So which is called anti-inflammatory hormones. Like I can say, glucocorticoids are anti-inflammatory agents, and also it depresses the immune response. It depresses the immune response. One more important function is that it helps to synthesis of RBC. These glucocorticoids stimulate the RBC synthesis or erythropoiesis, and it also known as stress combat hormone. There was stress combat hormone. So sometimes what happens, these secretions, the glucocorticoid secretes more, excess secretion will take place. This causes a disease. This is called Cushing syndrome. This is called Cushing syndrome. So these are the important functions of glucocorticoids. Once I will revise, these glucocorticoids, just example is cortisone and corticosteroid. Primarily meant for carbohydrate metabolism. Whenever we need more glucose, immediately this glucocorticoids stimulate the process of gluconeogenesis, that is called glucose formation from takes from non-carbohydrate particles, especially from proteins. So lipolysis means the lipids get break down to produce glycerol and fatty acids. So proteolysis means protein will break down into small amino acids. These amino acids are utilized by the body to form new proteins, for example enzymes. So these are the three important process. It's called life-saving process. So it is more essential for life-saving process. And one more important, cardiovascular and also kidney function. It acts as an anti-inflammatory reaction agent, and also it depresses the immune response, and also essential for RBC synthesis. It is otherwise called stress combat hormone. These are the important functions of glucocorticoids. And one more function I have told, that is called sex corticoids. This male androgen, this hormone helps in secondary sexual characters of male, especially the growth of hair in the pubis, especially in the pubis region or in the face region. This hair development takes place with the help of cis corticoids. So for adrenal cortex, three types of hormones we have told. One is called glucocorticoids, one is mineralocorticoids, one is cis corticoids. These are the important functions of adrenal cortex. Dear students, in this video we have discussed a lot of things about adrenal gland. I think it is very easy to understand. If it is easy, you please subscribe this channel and share this channel to your friends and your circles. Support us. Thank you.